slide off. Magwell's clear. Chamber's cleared. Just take the slide off and give you a better detailed look on the inner workings of what I did. So what I did is I drilled these holes with the number 42 drill bit. Made sure I stayed high enough on the plastic, but not too low where I didn't get enough metal with it, as you can see right there and right there. So I wanted to stay low so it had enough meat right here to really hold on to that locking block from the any abuse or, you know, whatever may happen. And how I did that is I got this end of the calipers, put it inside, made sure I was high enough on the plastic but low enough on the metal that I had enough material to grab with. Made my marks with the marker like this. Made sure I was even on both sides. Did a final double and triple check. And then drilled it out with the number 42 drill bit. Then drilled through the locking block. Once I got done drilling through the locking block, took the locking block out, tapped it with a 4-40 NC tap. Once I got done tapping the front locking block, I got the screws from the old Palmer 80 V1 models and put the screws through the locking block, made sure it all screwed in well. And made sure I took enough of the screws off. As what I mean by that is cut the screws down far enough so they wouldn't be sticking out and catching on the guide rod and spring. And once I did that and made sure everything was good, put the locking block back on, put the set screw inside. It wouldn't go all the way through because I still had to drill this hole bigger. So I took it back out, drilled it with the number 44 drill bit, and then set them in, used Loctite, and I was done. So I went and shot it today, put another 500 plus rounds through it, and didn't have no problems with it. Doesn't stick. Locking block does not move whatsoever. It's like it's molded in there, like a Glock lower factory one. Only issue I had was on the slide catch release. It moves around a lot from left to right. And if I was doing really fast firing, it wouldn't catch on the last round, so my slide wouldn't stay open. That's the only issue I had. If I was shooting it really slow, like shoot, stop, shoot, stop, shoot, I'd get it to lock back like this. But if I was really going at it, like shoot, 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 on the last round, the slide would go back into battery. And yeah, that's my only issue I'm having. I'm hoping I can somehow fix that. I was using these 9-rounders and I was having all sorts of problems with these guys right here. Bullets would get flipped around inside of here. Failure to feed. Had a lot of jamming with this mag right here. Definitely didn't like it. So I just stuck with the factory 6-rounder. Had no issues. Still had the problem though with the slide locking back on the last round. So let's go ahead and take this apart. So I'll give you one more good look at it. But I mean, it does not, nothing. That thing does not budge whatsoever. It's in there for good. And what's nice is you can always take it out and put a new trigger, whatever you want to do, whatnot, to the inside of it, because you got these screws. So as you can see, right there and right there. Definitely glad I did it. I'm happy now with this SS80. I'm having no remorse of buying it now that I was able to do this and get it done. So if you guys are gonna attempt it, be wary. It's not easy. It's definitely a tough task. I'm just hoping their next set of models that they come out with, they do something like this. So thanks for watching, and if you guys got any comments, let me know. Here to answer them, help you guys out. And you guys have a great one. Thanks.